I'm here at the Outlaws Boxing Club, where pretty much everyone here from this gym was on hand for the Chad Dawson, Bernard Hopkins fight at Staples Center. Boxing trainer Brandon Krause, what did you make of Linares against DeMarco?
Linares DeMarco was definitely the fight of the night. I had a feeling it was going to be a good scrap, and it lived up to his expectations. And it was, you know, it was a great drama from the beginning to the end. Linares, you know, slick, fast, nice moves, pretty punches. Seemed to be dominating slow DeMarco in the beginning, kind of pot shotting him, picking him off at will, and looking very good doing it. DeMarco seeming to get a little frustrated and getting more and more beat up. And about midway through the fight, I thought that Linares had it in the bag. I was even leaning over to the people behind me talking about what's going to be Linares' next step.
What did you think his next step was at that point?
I was talking about maybe him versus Brandon Rios. How would that match up? Maybe some of the other guys at lightweight.
So what changed in the fight? Because that was up to the sixth round.
Okay, so then, you know, there's these terrible cuts that open up all over Linares' face. And that bad one right on the bridge of his nose that had to be spouting blood into both of his eyes. And those were terrible cuts. I mean, they were just pouring blood. Every time his heart would beat, you could see it stream from one of those cuts on his face. And DeMarco started to stage a rally. And honestly, I thought, okay, you know, Linares is going to survive this. But DeMarco was landing good shots. And finally just kept landing them. And Linares wasn't answering back. And got stopped. I was pretty shocked, you know. I swear.
What did you think about the stoppage?
When I saw it happen, it seemed premature by the ref. But then Linares didn't complain whatsoever. I mean, there was no argument from Linares or his camp.
Maybe he's just a classy guy.
Or maybe he knew he was getting beat up. Maybe he knows that those punches were starting to take their toll. DeMarco was hitting him with some pretty clean shots. Linares' face looked like a horror movie. He couldn't see anything coming. Yeah, maybe he was just happy to have this fight ended. And now it's second knockout loss in Linares' career. And it's gonna be tough to make an A-plus career out of that now.
If they have a rematch, who wins?
Well, Linares was doing everything he was supposed to be doing, and he still didn't win the fight. And when fights happen like that, it's hard to think that he's going to do something that's going to discourage Tony DeMarco. You got to think that DeMarco, no matter how the fight goes, thinks...
Are you done walking your tire?
Oh, that's awesome. Yeah.
You're supposed to flip it the other way, coach. Not like that.
I don't flip nothing no more. I'm tired.
Is that what, 315 pounds?
Yeah.
Are you supposed to flip it and hit it with the hammer?
Oh, we'll be doing a lot of good stuff with that one.
That's very good.
But back to the fight. Yeah, you got to think no matter how it goes, DeMarco's going to think in his head, hey, I can knock this guy out. Even if I lose every second of every round, I can knock this guy out. That's basically how it went down. So I would say Tony DeMarco should be favored if they rematch, or Tony DeMarco can move on to another one of these lightweight names. Maybe Brandon Rios?
This was the first loss of Freddie Roach in a very, very long time.
Yeah, it was a tough loss because it was Linares' fight to win. And, DeMarco, a tough Mexican. He didn't back down. He didn't get discouraged. It was a war. There was ebb and flow. There was a turn of tides. It was a great fight.
Does Rios beat DeMarco if they fight?
Rios hits really hard. Rios doesn't have the greatest defense. It would be a great scrap. It would be a barn burner while it lasts. My prediction is Brandon Rios is a little bit too much of a puncher for Tony DeMarco. But I'm not going to rule out Antonio DeMarco in any fight after this.
There you have it. Stay tuned for more from the Outlaws Boxing Club in Tarzana for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Melly Setback reporting.
Make sure